My sister Elizabeth is very agreeable.
Perfectly tolerable, I dare say. Not handsome enough to tempt me.
Well, you're not what I was looking for. But your arms
so
are open at my door.
What do you mean? She must have a thorough knowledge of music.
And of course she must improve her mind by extensive reading.
I'm no longer surprised at your knowing only six accomplished women. I rather wonder now at your knowing any.
So what do you recommend to encourage affection?
Dancing. If one's partner is barely tolerable.
Will you dance, Mr. Darcy?
Not if I can help it.
You know my nephew.
Proud, Mr. Darcy. Would you consider pride a fault or a virtue?
That I couldn't say.
Because we're doing our best to find a fault in you.
To forgive the follies and vices of others, all their offences against me. My good opinion once lost is lost forever.
Mr. Darcy's here. I'd rather not. He's so...
So what?
He's so rich.
Handsome face.
I hope that the weather stays fine.
I return to town tomorrow.
So soon. They said that the house was open for visitors. I had no idea. So he separated them.
And those are the words of a gentleman. From the first moment I met you, your arrogance and conceit, your selfish disdain for the feelings of others, made me realize that you were the last man in the world I could ever be prevailed upon to marry.
The next dance, Miss Elizabeth.
Come in. I don't understand.
Hello. You have bewitched me, my dear soul. I never wish to be parted from our friends. How are you this evening, my dear?
Very well. Only I wish you would not call me my dear.
Why?
Because it's what my father always calls my mother when he's cross about something.
What endearments am I, Anna?
You may only call me Mrs. Darcy.
You really do that, don't you?
Very much. When you are completely and perfectly and incandescently happy.
And how are you this evening? Mrs. Darcy.